Believe it or not, last Halloween, Winnipeg escape artist Dean Gunnarsson defied death. He was buried alive in a tomb full of cement. Well, that feat landed Gunnarsson a two-page spread in Ripley's Believe It or Not, The Remarkable Revealed. It's a book which hits the store shelves today. Now, you probably remember Dean Gunnarsson. He was on our show last Halloween as he prepared for the big escape. He's back from Winnipeg this morning. Hello, Dean.
Good morning, Heather.
Good to see you again, all in one piece, at least. I mean, I can only see to your waist, but I think you're all in one piece. It's good to see you.
Most of me. I am missing a few body parts, but that's from another escape.
So. Listen, it is good to talk to you. I'm thinking that maybe there might be someone watching our conversation who doesn't remember our chat last year. So we're going to show some images of what you did last year. We're going to relive it with you. Take me through what you did in this escape, Dean.
Yeah, it was a remarkable escape. Again, it was something that had never been attempted by anybody anywhere in the world, including myself. And I was locked up in several pairs of police handcuffs. I was bound with chains around my arms and around my neck and padlock. And then I was placed into this plexiglass tomb. And then once I was inside the tomb was filled with 2.5 tons of wet concrete. Now, once I was completely submerged in the concrete, then the lid was locked on with 6 maximum security padlocks, and I had to escape. And again, this was done with no smoke, no mirrors, and no camera tricks. I had to escape as the weight of the concrete was pushing in on my lungs and suffocating and crushing me, kind of wrapping me up like a python and sucking the life out of me.
I'm getting the chills of remembering this as I look at the images today. Good thing you don't have a monitor there, or you might have the fears as you're watching this. But remember what a cold day it was? It was snowing and everything. It wasn't very pleasant for you.
You know what? In Winnipeg, we had a huge snowfall the night before. And, you know, the people involved wanted to cancel it. But, you know, being a Canadian and I think, you know, part of it is overcoming obstacles and challenges. And it just made us push harder to do it. But yes, the cold definitely had an effect on the escape. It made it more difficult. And then to top it off, my assistant's vehicle was stolen the night before that had some equipment that we needed. So there was a lot of things against it. So it really made it a remarkable, believe it or not, escape. It was perfect for the new Ripley's
Well,
book.
Perfect for our segue to where this story goes next, because we can have your feet captured on videotape. Now the whole thing is captured in this book, Ripley's Believe It or Not. You have the book there, I know. Hold it. We have it on our screen,
oh,
too.
Yeah.
Did you get one of the first copies off the press?
This is it. You can still smell the ink. I mean, it is an amazing book.
How did it come about, your two-page spread in that?
Well, you know, I've been escaping all my life. I got my first book on Houdini when I was about 10 years old, and things just kind of grew from there. And I travel around the world getting out of all kinds of things, being chained up, thrown out of airplanes, locked in cars and crushed, locked in shark cages underwater, coffins and stuff. So, you know, my whole life has been, you know, a Ripley's Believe It or Not story almost. Mm-hmm. And so, you know, Ripley's had featured different escapes that I'd done over the years. And in fact, my first one was 25 years ago when I was still a teenager. I hung from the old Winnipeg Free Press building here in Winnipeg, the same place that Houdini had escaped from in 1923. And I kind of got out faster than he did, and they'd started that.
Wow.
So it's been a long running with history with Ripley's. And, you know, I'm so proud and honored as a performer, as a Canadian, to be featured in something that has such worldwide appeal and distribution. And you know, I've traveled the world, I've seen strange and weird things and oddities, and I almost feel like Mr. Ripley sometimes. And so it's really a great honor to be involved with The Remarkable Revealed.
So that's like the who's who. For escape artists, being in Ripley's is like the who's who. It's a big deal, isn't it, to be in that book?
Yeah, it's really good. And like I said, the escape that we did last Halloween was seen around the world. Like it was that amazing to people. And again, it was a huge struggle and overcoming the obstacles with myself. So, you know, again, it's been captured on video, and now it'll be, you know, captured in the hearts and minds in this book for a little part of history, and just helps me in my role of trying to become the greatest escape artist of all time and surpassing my mentor, the great Houdini.
Dean, good to talk to you. Thank you for the update. Congratulations on your honor.
Yeah, Oh, my pleasure. The next great escape is just around the corner.
Oh, we'll be following. Dean Gunnarsson, I'll let you escape from our program for now. We'll check back with you again, Dean. Thank you. We're going to take a quick break on